Many split air conditioners have these filters installed. If these filters become excessively dirty, see, these filters are very dirty, the air circulation will significantly decrease, which can trigger an F3 error. Usually, this error indicates a fault in the outdoor unit, but it can also occur due to problems with the indoor unit. Additionally, if the evaporator gets dirty, observe here, if there's excessive dust or blockage, this can also cause the unit to show an F3 error. Another reason could be that if the temperature is extremely high and the gas pressure is also elevated, this can also cause the same issue. What happens is, when the temperature rises excessively, the gas molecules expand, causing the compressor to work harder. As a result, the unit can display the F3 error. Additionally, this is the outdoor unit, and this part is its condenser. If this condenser becomes extremely dirty, right now it's clean, but just for your understanding, if it becomes clogged, dusty, or its fins, pores get blocked, this can also trigger an F3 error. Another reason could be that if the outdoor unit's fan isn't functioning properly, if it's not operating correctly, has stopped, or is jammed, then the unit can also display an F3 error, especially if it has an AC fan motor. Additionally, look at the outdoor PCB. This is its connector. If for any reason, this connector has a loose connection, it can also cause the F3 issue. Furthermore, the wiring running from the PCB to the compressor terminals can also trigger this error if there is any mistake. For instance, if even one of these wires is improperly connected or burnt, the unit may also display an F3 error. Another possible issue could be related to electricity. If there's any fluctuation in the electrical supply, this problem could arise. This electrical issue can be temporary as well. The faults mentioned previously could also be temporary. By thoroughly cleaning the filters and condenser, you might resolve this issue. However, if the issue occurs due to electricity, it can be either temporary or permanent. In this case, unplug the unit for about half an hour and then plug it back in. This might fix the error. But if the electrical fluctuation causes a permanent fault in the unit, then let's discuss the potential reasons behind this permanent damage. Now let me explain the reason behind a permanent fault. Here, I have two PCBs that have come for repair. The manufacturer has termed this issue as an IPM fault, meaning if the IPM becomes faulty, the unit will display an F3 error on the screen. Observe, this is the IPM module. When it gets damaged or short-circuited, replacing it will resolve the F3 error. Besides this, the diode associated with it can also become faulty or short-circuited. Sometimes it might function intermittently, causing the F3 error. Similarly, if the IGBT is damaged or short-circuited, this can also lead to the same problem. Additionally, there are some diodes here. Let me show you their numbers clearly, D28, D27, and D26. If any of these diodes become faulty, they can trigger the F3 error, since failing to properly pass the required 15 volts can result in this issue. Moreover, if this capacitor becomes short-circuited, it can also potentially cause the F3 error to appear. Now, I'll show you the voltages on the IPM to help you better understand how many volts should be present here. Let's supply power to the PCB. Now observe, two PCBs arrived for repair. One had a faulty IPM, which I have already replaced, along with the IGBT. The diodes on this PCB were completely fine. In contrast, the second PCB has only a faulty IPM, while its IGBT and diodes are perfectly fine, requiring only an IPM replacement. This demonstrates clearly that faults can occur individually in the IPM, the IGBT, or even the diodes. Now, set your multimeter to DC volts. I've prepared the entire setup here, with the reactor attached as well. Let's provide electricity to the unit now, and I'll show you what the correct voltages should be when the unit is functioning properly. Additionally, we'll discuss what other components might be faulty if the unit still doesn't start. I've powered up the PCB. You can see the lights have turned on, one light is blinking, and the red indicator is also illuminated. The multimeter is set on DC volts. Here, let me show you. There are three main points. The first two points at the start remain empty, with no voltages present. Next to these, we have the positive point, followed by U, V, W, and then the negative point. Let's check them. Place the negative probe on the negative point and the positive probe on the positive terminal. You should see around 300 VDC, here clearly visible at the positive point. Moving on, the next points U, V, and W should each measure around 15 volts DC. If you see approximately 15 volts at each of these points, U, V, and W, this indicates that the IPM is functioning correctly. Additionally, if the unit still isn't starting despite correct IPM voltages, the issue could lie within the low side components. Specifically, faults in the IGBT or its associated driver circuit can cause such problems. Another common cause is the low side diodes. If any of these components fail, they can also trigger the F3 error. Therefore, carefully inspect these components, including the low-side diodes and the IGBT, for faults or short circuits. By thoroughly checking these areas, I hope you'll successfully resolve the F3 error from your unit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.